Before you watch the video, I want to give you a little bit of background into why it is that I'm looking at a grave with the name of Moseley on it, when Moseley, the Moseley name doesn't crop up at all in our family history. The reason I'm looking at it is because I went on a bit of a detective journey just before Christmas, and in fact during Christmas, and it all came about because of this. About 30 years ago, Sue bought a job lot of antique jewellery at an auction room, and it was mainly brooches, nothing of any great value, but inside it was this little brooch. And we noticed when we got it home, it's a little 9-carat gold mourning brooch, and we noticed when we got home that it had actually got some plaited hair in the back of it. I don't know if you can see that. And above that little window was some engraving, and getting the eyeglass out, it was it had the name of Anne Moseley on it and a date of death in 1865. And we didn't really think much more about that. We just put it away. She obviously took out the items that were of interest to her, and this got put in a drawer and forgotten about, basically. Anyway, about 6 months ago, I suppose it would be, it saw the light of day again, and I took another look at it and I thought, you know, I could find out what happened to Anne Moseley and who she was and where she lived and what she did. And obviously with the internet now, we hadn't got the internet when we bought the jewellery. So I started a bit of research about her, and it, like all research, it ballooned and ballooned and mushroomed, and I ended up doing quite a lot of historical research into the Moseley family as a whole. And the result of all that research was this book. Well, it's, I call it a book, it's about 20 odd pages long, and it's basically writing up all what I found out about the Moseleys. It's quite an interesting story. It's got tragedy, it's got love, it's got romance, it's got death, it's got intrigue. So I thought, well, this makes quite an interesting story, and I need to find out where Anne's grave is. I'd already discovered that it was in Nottingham Road Cemetery. And as I go to Nottingham Road to look at me, look after my grandfather's grave, I thought, I'm going to find out where it is, go on, you know, see if I can find it. And we found it quite quickly, really. It said on the headstone that Anne was the fourth wife of Henry Moseley, which immediately thought, what happened to the other three? So I just had to find out. And so anyway, all that's detailed in that document there. And if you're interested in reading it, if you send me an email address, I'll send you a PDF copy of it and you can read it. But anyway, I'll stop waffling now and let you watch the video. But that's the reason why I'm looking at Moseley graves. Nothing at all to do with Hopkins's. It was just something that developed, really. I won't say it was an obsession, but it gripped me. When I started finding out about the family, it gripped me, and I really wanted to get to the bottom of what happened to them. There are no surviving descendants of the Moseley family, as far as I've been able to ascertain. The two children from Henry and Anne's marriage both died as spinsters, so they didn't have children, so the family basically died out in the 1930s, which is maybe why this came up in a sale room, because obviously you would expect that to remain in the family, but I don't think the family exists anymore, so that's really why it came up. Anyway, I'm going to stop waffling, let you watch the video. I hope you enjoy it. Hope I don't bore you too much. Give it a thumbs up if you like it when you've watched it, and I'll try and keep making some more.
Nottingham Road Cemetery in Derby. I'm standing in the new cemetery, but what I'm interested in is across the road. That building behind me is the main chapel to the cemetery. I'm going to go in the cemetery, we're going to have a look at a couple of graves. I'm going to explain a little bit about them, and I hope you're going to find what I've got to show you of interest. I'm here at Nottingham Road Cemetery in Derby, and I've come to look at a couple of graves that aren't connected with our family, but I've done a little bit of research on this family, and quite a few interesting facts emerged. So I've come to just have a look at the gravestones. This grave is to Anne Moseley, and she was the fourth wife of Henry Moseley, who was a jeweller in Derby in the 19th century. There's also a memorial to Anne's niece, whose name was Fanny Vernon. But as you can see, Anne died on the 17th of April, 1865. Anne was only 56 when she died. Her husband, Henry Moseley, he died on January the 19th, 1869, and he was 65 when he died. And they're both interred in this spot. Just to the right of Anne and Henry's grave is this one, and this one is quite interesting. It's Henry's son, who was also called Henry, Henry George, and he was only 20 when he died, and he died on April the 26th, 1855. This grave is interesting because this was the very first burial in this cemetery. As I said, mentioned before, it was 1855, and sadly, within 10 days of Henry dying, his sister Rosamond also died, and she was buried in the same grave. When we came to look for this grave, we didn't realise that it was actually right next to Anne and Henry, and it was rather overgrown, and the soil at the side of the stone had encroached onto the stone. So this morning I've just cleared it, cleared the soil back and given it a sweep, and you can see the different coloration is where the soil was. What I'm going to do in a minute is just pour some water on the stone and give it a gentle brush with the sweeping brush and see if it brings the lettering out a bit. I have actually photographed the lettering. Fortunately, we've got a bit of sunshine, so it's throwing a shadow into the letters, which makes it easier to read. But I'm quite pleased that we've found this one, because this is a significant grave within this cemetery. Right, I've wet it. I'm not sure whether it's any better or whether it's worse, but I think it's quite legible now. I'll take a couple of still photographs, and for a grave hunter, that's a nice find. I'm pleased we've located it. Right, I'm going to pan down the gravestone slowly, and hopefully the camera will pick up the inscription. So this is the cemetery. I just pan round and get an idea of the size of it, and it's right on the edge of Derby, really, on the Spondon end. You can probably hear the roads in the background. It's quite a busy area for roads, but within the cemetery itself there's a peace, which is nice. Okay, so that's Anne and Henry Moseley and their children. And now I'm going to look at another Moseley grave, which is a little bit further in that direction, a bit closer to the chapel. And I'll tell you a bit about that when we get there. I'll put the camera on while we're wheeling the wheelbarrow through, so you can get a sense of this area of the cemetery. Very peaceful. Some lovely memorial stones. It'd take weeks to look at everyone and appreciate them. They've all got a story to tell. So we're going to turn up here now. So we're headed towards the chapel, the main chapel. And this is at the Nottingham Road end of the cemetery. And somewhere close by are two flat stones that I'm interested in looking at. It's certainly a lovely day. So, at this end of the cemetery, two more graves that I'm interested in looking at. These two enormous stone slabs are also related to the Moseleys. The one on the left is Robert Moseley, who was Henry's uncle. And Robert's wife was Anne Moseley, who died on December the 30th, 1863, aged 81. Now, I'm not sure of this connection, but there's quite a few inscriptions to Mountfords and Mountford Holmeses and Holmeses. They were obviously part of the Moseley family by marriage. And they're on this slab as well. The one adjacent is John Mountford. And there's a Holmes. There's two Holmeses. But again, this is a huge slab, but at the top end there's a lot of moss growing in the inscription, so I'm just going to scrape that out so we can read what it says. The size of these headstones must be, well, 4 foot in width, and I would say 10, maybe 11 feet in length. They're huge. If you compare them to the other graves, this grave at the side, you can get a sense of the scale of the thing. But they're very impressive. Right, so I've cleaned Robert Moseley's headstone, and you can see the letters now. I've actually left some moss there. Anybody who's got a patio will know how moss grows in the grooves. Well, that's just how this was. Sacred to the memory of Robert Moseley of Derby, who died 11th of June 1856, aged 80 years. Also of Anne Moseley, widow of the above, who died December the 30th, 1863, aged 81. Also of Herbert Mountford Holmes, died April the 5th, 1893, aged 78. And of Charles Holmes, sorry, son of Charles Holmes and Anne, his wife, afterwards married to the above named Robert Moseley. Also Ellen Holmes, died November the 26th, 1893, aged 74, widow of the above and daughter of Robert Moseley by his first wife. So that's Robert Moseley and a number of his family's final resting place in Nottingham Road Cemetery in Derby. And next to Robert Moseley, we have this one, which reads, sacred to the memory of John Mountford, formerly of Lichfield, who died 27th of January 1858, aged 69 years. Also of George Edward Holmes, who died December the 16th, 1916, aged 67 years. Charles Holmes, died November the 14th, 1927, aged 83 years. and the rest of the stone has no inscriptions.
Below those two slabs is another grave, which I think is related, and the inscription reads, "In loving memory of Herbert Mountford Holmes, born July 22nd, 1847, died May 22nd, 1929. And there's his, presumably it's his wife below, but that's a little bit overgrown and I can't read it. I'm not going to bother cleaning that one up. So after a bit of investigation, I managed to locate the two Moseley graves. The one we've already seen under the tree, that was Anne and Henry. And this one, Robert, who was Henry's uncle. And I don't think they always got on. They were partners in a business, but that created some friction between the two of them. So Robert Moseley, the uncle of Henry, lies behind me in Nottingham Road in Derby. Just cleaned the inscription up on the gravestones. So I'm pleased I've done that, really, because I did some research into the Moseley family, and you read a name in a newspaper and it doesn't really mean anything. When you find out where they are laid to rest, and you know a little bit about the history of the family, it makes it quite rewarding for me anyway. I find it rewarding to do this, even to the extent of cleaning up a grave that really doesn't really have any connection with me whatsoever, other than the fact that I've done a little bit of research into their lives. This is the Great War Memorial to the men of Nottingham Road, Derby. It could do with a little bit of a clean up, but it obviously is visited. For God, King and Country. I'm not going to read all the names because they're quite difficult to read. So that's the Great War Memorial in memory of the men of Nottingham Road, Derby, who gave their lives and all those who served. Before I go to my granddad's grave, I'm going to go to my uncle's grave, Francis Ernest Hopkins, otherwise known as Frankie. He died as a child. He's in an unmarked grave, but I do happen to know where it is. So we'll go and have a look. So we're on the southern edge of the Nottingham Road Cemetery now. Quite close to the A52, you can probably hear the hum of the traffic. It's about 150 yards away. And along here is where my uncle Frankie is buried. So here, next to Alfie Kerry, is Francis Ernest Hopkins. He hasn't got a grave that's discernible, but I do know this is where he's buried because I inquired at the cemetery office when I first visited and they marked it with a little marker. Francis Ernest Hopkins, always known as Frankie to the family, was born on the 2nd of November 1911. His baptism took place on the 3rd of January 1912, and unfortunately he died on the 7th of March 1917, and he was brought here for burial on the 11th of March 1917.
So that's Uncle Frankie in Nottingham Road Cemetery. There's some nice spring flowers just starting to appear quite close by where he's buried. We're on the outer limits of the cemetery at this point, and this circle just here, this mound, was a focal point for the old original entrance. And the original entrance was down there. Where you see the traffic at the moment, that used to be the Derby Canal. I've been told that coffins used to come by boat to arrive at the bottom there, and there's a nice avenue of trees, and they used to proceed up this incline, up these steps and into the cemetery. I don't know whether there was ever a cross or some other sort of obelisk at the top of this mound, but it's nice to think that there might have been. There are a couple of graves down here, unusually. Doesn't appear to be part of the body of the cemetery, but there's one there to Sarah Chambers, who died 1894. There's another one over there, and there's a couple of war graves there. I can't read them because they're facing the other way. It seems a shame that these are down here away from the main cemetery. So this is the way that the coffins would arrive. When this cemetery was open, this was all rural, no hum of traffic. So that's the view towards the A52 and Pride Park and the Wyvern. And again, if it wasn't for the traffic, it would be a really peaceful corner of the cemetery. Not many headstones, but I'd suspect plenty of graves. Plenty of unmarked graves. And as we're round the corner by this brush, we arrive at the Commonwealth War Graves Commission plot of the cemetery. There are isolated graves all over the cemetery, war graves, but this is the main concentration of war graves in the cemetery. There are graves from both wars here, and there are a number of German graves as well, which are just here. There's the cross of sacrifice at the end of this row. These Germans obviously died after the end of the war. All 1946 burials. There's a 1947 one. Whether they were prisoners of war or not, I really don't know. And that's an Italian. There's another Italian. 1945, among those of the Allies. And there's a cross of sacrifice, and it looks like it's got a poppy rock on it. Yes, it has. The Great War casualties tend to be on the left-hand side and they're notable for having darker stones than the Second War casualties, which are to the right. And then there are an odd couple of civilian graves in the same plot. Now coming away from the south end of the cemetery where the A52 was and the background noise, and I'm approaching my granddad's grave, which is along here on the right. There's a beautiful patch of snowdrops coming up. The snowdrops, absolutely abundant in this area, beautiful. From that you will have gathered we're in February. Among all these grey and mossy headstones, there's a white one that stands out from the crowd, and that's my granddad. This is my granddad's grave. They've cut all the trees down around here, you can see all the stumps, but this area was shaded, completely shaded with trees. And at the back, the grave behind had a huge holly tree growing in it, which you can see has now been cut down, so it's opened it up to the light, which is better really, and hopefully there won't be so many leaves around next autumn. I'll try and keep it presentable. Hopefully it will be a little bit easier now the trees have gone and the source of the moss. But we've just been to Frankie's grave, and here's his memorial on the curb and my granddad's grave. And the other memorial on the grave is to my auntie Dorothy, married Arthur B. Stall. And Dorothy is actually in this grave. She is one of only two people in the grave, the other being my grandfather. It's just possible to locate my granddad's grave, the white one about there, and I'm standing at the side of the Moseley grave. So they're more or less within sight of one another. And this one's come up all right now, it's still drying out, but it's readable. So that's the end of my afternoon at Nottingham Road Cemetery. I've cleaned a few graves up, I've cleared a bit of moss, I've levelled a bit of soil, I've taken a few photographs, and most of all I've paid respects to the people that are here. Hope you've enjoyed the video. I'll be in another cemetery soon.